Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Betrayal. Krondor is brought to us all by Jason. As per usual, we are just jumping on in here, and before we get too deep, this is going to be a slightly short episode. My limited time to record is more limited than usual, but that's okay. So last time we met a kobold here that wanted some plate. I'm gonna see if we can just swing over. Hey, I was waiting for like something to grab us as we went across, but we got lucky. So we'll keep poking around. I do have more rope, right? All right, one more use. So I'm gonna have to be careful or I'm gonna end up getting trapped in here, which probably not the best thing to happen. We have, is that rubble? I think that's rubble. Nothing else, okay. Let's see what's up. Nothing and nothing. Okay, so it looks like we have two exits. We will head north because why not? And it didn't. All right. Oh, and the lights have gone out. Torch! Can I just, like, will this, like, strike a new one? Yes, it will. Wonderful. All right, so this is our last torch, so we're gonna have to start using magic for our light, which is not a big deal. Not worried. Okay, oh. A door, locked. What does it take? We don't have a Gildas Thorn that will fit. We'll have to deal with the Keymaker somewhere. All right, and you can't pick it then? No. Oh, hey. Grant's abilities have increased. Lockpicking 35. So can he just like keep going at this? I know I mentioned that last episode. And normally I check comments, but I haven't had time lately to check comments. I'll run through lockpicks on this thing to 10. And I think that'll be it. All right. Nope, still 35. All right, figured I'd check. Okay, yeah. Another hall. This place is a lot larger than I was expecting it to be. I honestly wasn't, I wasn't expecting there to be another level to it. Ooh. Nothing. All right, cool. I'll take it. Rando loot. Untrapped chest. The system works. And another dead end. Okay. So we will continue on. I want to look at my map really quick. Wow. Okay, I was not. Wow, alright. I was wondering if this was gonna, like, meet up with this branch down here, but we're going pretty far out. I don't know. Let's go east, or north, rather. Oh, what is that? A Brachnur! Okay. So things that were previously bosses are now basic enemies. I guess I can appreciate that. Oh, let's see how this goes. The ground shook. Startled, Owen braced himself against the earthen wall of the mine, his wide eyes fixed on the titanic creature lumbering towards them. Brachnur, glancing over his shoulder at Gorath, Owen sighed. This is going to be harder than I thought. Oh, really? Really? Let's see if that's the case. Can we grief it? I'll just do 6. Harder than he thought! And by harder than he thought, he meant not hard at all. Oh, that is like so cheesy! If enemies have resisted, like, if they aren't resistant to that one-on-one, like, nothing can beat us. That's crazy. Alright, we actually have some stairs. Must be the passage to Elvendor, noted Owen. If we go this way, it may take us a few hours to get to the end. Are we up to the climb now? No. We're We're not gonna check that out yet. There's more caverns to explore. Oh, fuck! Owen flailed. His last impressions were of a dark shaft and hard-packed earth rising to greet him. Damn it. Thankfully, I just saved before I killed that thing. We actually might have to go to Elvendar to get rope if we're gonna explore. So I guess that's where we're gonna go. Okay, grief of a thousand knights. 5 rounds should suffice. Jeez. Gorath is just a monster. All right. Hours passed, just as Owen was beginning to wonder if they would ever see the light of day again. The walls of the stairwell widened and were illuminated by dim shafts of light piercing the darkness through an oaken door. Pushing it open, Owen gasped at the marvel of a leafy canopy which spread above them. Oh wow, I wasn't expecting like wilderness area here, I was expecting it to just open into a town. They were not alone. Goron's pulse quickened as he saw the lone figure approach, but when it became apparent they were not being attacked, he relaxed a bit, squinting slightly to an attempt to see who was about to join them.
You couldn't have come at a better time.
Connor Bandoc. It's an awful mess from here out. Wyverns have come in over the mountains and have cinched things up a bit. If we hadn't beaten back flames this past few weeks, we'd been through a month sooner. I don't know how many roads are possible at this stage, Captain. What kid of yourn that come and helped us clear out the mess in the mine left out as soon as word reached that the fires were approaching Elvendar? Where did the wyverns come from? Where else, lad? The Northlands! Some new bastard Mordhall leader I hear harassing your kinfolk. I hope you haven't any kits in harm's way. No, what of the Mordhall? Few as what had the nerve to cross over from the moorland have already got themselves skewered. Though I know that Prince Caelan has been on the frontier looking for others. The biggest concern as yet is to put the flames out and get help as to those that got trapped behind it all. Alright. Prince Caelan leads. What of war leader Thomas? Poor news indeed. 3 days ago, Thomas led a band of elves to stem raiders that had come over the river near Mordalin. They beat the raiders back at right, but in the melee, the warlord took a thrust to his side with a tainted blade. They had to carry him back to Elvendar, though I understand it wasn't without a struggle. Thomas wanted to stay, but word was carried back to Algaron that his condition was then the end of that. Prince Caelan assumed control of the thralls at that point, and I Kenny's still up near the eastern fringe of the forest, carving up Mordhall. Does the war leader yet live? Ah, that lad has ever been a fighter, and a tenacious one at that. Sooner or let them cut a leg off than succumb to this poison. I wouldn't worry. I think it took your kin for a turn through seeing Thomas fall. I've never heard of it happening in the 15 years he's been with your folk. So apparently this Thomas fellow is a badass. We required an Elvendar quickly. You mentioned fires. Extinguished now, although not without a fair portion of foot stomping and bucket carrying. But for a while, the whole forest might come all in one ferocious blaze. But Tathar and the rest of Queen Algla... These words, like, they keep throwing these fucking names out. And it's hard enough for me to do shitty voices for all the NPCs. And then they're like, here's like a 30-syllable elf name. The rest of the Queen's Spellweavers managed to put an alt to that business. Then you should have no difficulty returning to Elvendar. Well, I don't know how to exactly say that. There's still a fair number of those wyverns flapping about the forest. Oh, Telthar's been working day and night to bring the blighters down. Even taught Prince Callan a little bit of spellcraft what can bend the will of those cantankerous lizards, but I understand it still hasn't put an alt to the raids. And of the dwarves? Oh, we volunteered a few men, but as you elves don't much like outsiders in your realm, we've respected your borders. King Dolgan did send a few volunteers to help out with the Elf Queen, but a lot of them took a terrible weariness once they entered the forest and couldn't go further. They must have fell afoul of one of your fabled sleeping glades. Alright. We may face wyverns, it might be wise if we had our armor repaired. Are there any armor crafters in Kaldara? Are there any leaves in Elvendar? You've gone daft. Of course there's armor crafters in Kaldara. You don't have to go all the way though. I can repair it for a few gold, and if you watch close, you might even learn a bit about the craft of repairing armor. Does 100 sovereigns serve you? Yes. Suits me fine. What do we need to do? Well, lad, I'd be much obliged if you'd remove any armor you might have on under that tunic of yours. If your friend will do the same, we'll get to work. Now just watch what I do. Someone once told me a few dents in the armor can actually be beneficial. Something about them catching blows, that would ordinarily scrape along the surface and into the chinks. Makes some sort of sense when you think about it, I suppose. It would be a good idea to make armor so that it already has bumps, facets. If it had already had them built in, then the armor... You're already finished? Aye, finished. You'll find your armor's in as good a condition as it can be, lad. I dare say you'd have learned a great deal more if you spent more time listening and less time talking. Alright. Our abilities have increased. That's all for Gorath right there. 67. Zero. That idol is just like completely borking any usefulness Owen would have. And yeah, our armor's at 100. For 100 sovereigns? Yeah, I'm totally gonna do that. Okay, so we've got like a dwarf town in Elfville. Alright, so here's Caldera. And I guess we have this whole forest to explore now. Oh, Jesus. There's a lot to this chapter, I can already tell. Well, town's this way. So we might as well see if there's a shop, because I do have crap to sell. Gorath Yond, we need to ask. Well, I think this is probably an inn. It used to be a tavern. Oh, it's abandoned, though. Alright, you guys get to nap. I'll give you a whole day. There you go. Oh, and we can just... Gorath halted. Blinking slowly, he put a hand over his stomach, then looked towards his confused-looking companion.
Halt a moment, Owen. I wish to speak to you.
Why? What is it?
I merely wish to prepare you for things that may transpire before we reach Elvendar. There are magics, things ancient, which have kept the Mordhall from crossing into the forest of the Elendhall. But I feel those things have been awakened. I may have some difficulty in completing our journey.
Difficulty? What do you mean?
It was not my intent to alarm you, only to reassure you that no matter what may happen between here and Elvendar, I have come to consider you a friend.
Okay. So you're gonna get, like, Ponfar or something? It used to be a shop, no one's home. Shit! Seriously? Abandoned! Random gems. We do have some inventory space, so we'll take it. Alright. Can I use... Anything good floating around? No, just the houses. Okay. And a well. I don't trust wells since those last ones. Owen banged on the door with the side of his fist. After a moment, a man's voice called out from inside. What do you want? Could you give us some fresh water for our pouches? Asked Owen. There's a well just down the road. Now leave me alone. For the conversation didn't seem worth the effort, so they left. Okay. Owen answered the first knock, so Owen knocked again. Finally, a hoarse voice called to them, heavy with a dwarven accent.
Who's calling me?
We come from the kingdom. Can we come in? Owen asked.
Aye, the door's open. Do as you like.
They opened the door and entered a dimly lit room, sparsely furnished. In one corner, they could make out a shape, apparently lying on a bedroll.
Come in, rest your bones a minute, said the dwarf in a tired voice.
With his eyes closed, as though he were seeing the event on the inside of each lid, he told them of his journey from Kaldar and of the wyverns he had been had seen circling Elvendar.
The bloody Mordhall are roaming about, too. Took a sword in the side from one of them.
He rolled over and they could see the deep gash extending from his hip, halfway up to his hairy back. Can we do anything for you? Owen winced at the gaping wound.
Nah, looks worse than it is. Just need a few more days to rest up, that's all.
They wished him well and left quietly. Alright. I'll see what the damn well does. Where is it? Ah! Forest well! Just came out of the trees, took three men with it. Just a well, alright. Sometimes a well is just a well. So is this an actual shop? Yes! Split tree goods! Oh, you guys, I may have things. Actually, I don't have it. Holy shit, I don't have anything to sell except for this. 50 sovereigns. I don't mean to brag. We're rolling it. Oh, that's so expensive. Key of lineages. Damn it. Fucking flip past it again. Even an untrained artisan would be considered a fool if he failed to recognize the Elven Key of Lineages. Three interlocking triangles form the head of the long steel key, their matrix representing the ancient Midkemian tribes of the Elendhall, the Mordhall, and the Glamridhel. I'm gonna buy one of those, because we haven't seen one yet, and powder bags! These are the pocket sand, right? Yes. Oh, how high can these things stack is my question. Well, he has 12. Alright, rope goes to Gorath. For 80 sovereigns, you bet your ass I'm stocking up on those things. do not need rations. I'm gonna buy more rope, though. I wonder if these will stack. They do. How high? Alright, I'm gonna leave it at 12. I'm not gonna try pushing any further than that. Say we're okay on food. I'm gonna buy... Shit, he's out of torches. I'm actually okay with that. Buy some anti-venom. Because if we're gonna be fighting elves, I fully expect there to be bullshit. Alright, damn it. Let me leave your shop. I have enough goods, and this place apparently seems to be, like, kind of buying anything, so that's alright. So we'll poke around a little bit more here before we call it. I'm waiting. There's gotta be, like, horrible monsters. Just, like, there's wyverns. We fought drakes, I think, before. It's, like, never a good idea to just be... What is that? That's totally a thing right there. Oh, that's a plant. Alright. I mean, I wasn't wrong. It was a thing. It looked like a cat or something in the distance, and I was like, tigers? Does this game have forest jaguars? Panthers? Whatever the hell the terminology would be. Uh-oh. Growth motioned for silence. That had been years since he had led his kin through the skirts of the Elotel Forest on their escape from the Green Heart. The sights and smells were as familiar to him as the lines on the tips of his fingers. Yet there was an unnatural feeling in the area they stood in. Something moves nearby, but it is not one of our blood or any forest animal whose movement sounds I know. I thought I was hearing something. A high-pitched sort of whine, coming from the north? It's the same sound. Might be to our benefit if we were to see what its source is. What if it's something that thinks we look like dinner? Well, if it wishes us harm, better that we know what stalks us and have the advantage in attack than to allow it to come and eat us when it chooses the moment, don't you think? The choice is yours. Alright, to the north. Well, I mean, I'm gonna save. And if there's anything out here that's gonna eat us, I'm really not afraid because Gorath will probably eat it first, if I had to guess. It sounded like distant war drums. Owen stopped and cocked one ear, a puzzled expression on his face. He was about to comment on the strange sound when a cool wind suddenly kicked up swirls of dust around him. Looking up, he was terrified to see the sound was not caused by the beating of drums. It was the beating of a very large pair of wings. The creature landed, prepared for combat. Okay. The enemy crept toward them. We're going to have to fight. Owen, oh, that was Owen. Whatever, we're gonna murder it. All right, so we have, I assume these are wyverns. Can I lock them down? Let's find out. Yup, Gorath, get in there. Oh, they have spells. But they're not bad, just a little breath weapon. Certainly nothing that Owen can't take care of. Alright, Gorath, actually get some rest. Let you guys recharge your health and mana here. Alright, Gorath, you should be good. Wow, alright, these things are not nearly as... damn it. Not nearly as nasty as I thought they were gonna be if Gorath is, like, one-shotting them. Yeah, okay. The battle was won! Do they have anything? No. I suppose I shouldn't be surprised, being that they're natural creatures. Okay, well, hey, you know, every little bit. I say it's XP, but it's really not. We are gonna, however, rest until morning. Okay. I have no idea where I'm going. I'm just kinda... random pull cord in the forest. Can I climb up into the trees, or is this like, I'm gonna pull down bees? Owen was about to knock on the door when he heard loud voices coming from inside the small house. He listened, but couldn't make out what was being said. He was about to knock again when the door swung open, and three very loud and seemingly very drunk dwarves came charging out.
All that sand on the banks of the endless sea. That's what's left of all the Brachnors I've killed, that's right.
Don't you- The Brangendorf stopped when he saw Owen and Gorath, and turned to face his friends, a look of surprise and concern clearly displayed on his bearded face.
What are you doing here?
He demanded, eyes shifting to something behind Gorath. We're headed to Elvendar, Owen said.
Best you be going then, it's quite a ways north of here. He gestured to his friends, but rather than leaving, they went back inside the house. One felt eyes on the back on his back as they turned to leave. I wonder where they were going. They obviously didn't want us to follow them. Oh, really? Well, at least now I know I'm supposed to be going north. I'm gonna leave that. Oh god, I'm never gonna be able to find my way back here. Man. Like, it would help if I had, like, a little tick on the map showing me where Elvendar was so I knew where I was walking. But at least we know it's to the north. We'll just stick to the road. Because, another one. Okay, so these are tree houses. Alright. I love it. It's just like a freaking rope just kind of floating there in the air. It's adorable. Alright, I think that's a bridge. Bridges are positive. Bridges mean civilization. Oh, shit. I saw the frickin' wyvern sitting there in front of the bridge. We turn around and they'll simply pounce on us as if we were mice. Gorath laughed bitterly. I think mice would have a better chance. Gorath, ye of little faith. See, I got plans. Like, okay, so this thing attacks Gorath. He'll tank it. Does it go for Owen? Well, if it goes for Owen, he's just gonna pocket sand it. So it's like, they can't win, because I don't think they're gonna be able to one-shot either of these guys. Alright, we're just gonna hit this one with a little one, because it's not gonna live long enough. Alright, give these guys a chance to rest up. I still feel kind of cheap doing this, but... God damn it. But not that cheap. So Gorath is fully buffed, murdering everything. Mice would have a better chance. I'm pretty sure Gorath could wrestle one of those things to the ground if he wanted to, and then beat it to death with its own tail or something. See, there's some fan art. Any of you artistic folks out there, picture of Gorath strangling a wyvern to death with its own tail. All right, we have Gildas Thorn. Gorath puzzled over the heavily lacquered wooden key. I could be wrong, but I believe this is a Gildas Thorn, he said. As I understand it, the dwarves were amused that the Surani traders used wood instead of metal to manufacture their gourds, and the dwarven name for the Surani key stuck. We needed one of those, didn't we? And some arrows, which I don't really care about. Let's see, can I look at my key ring? Yeah, we needed one of those. Oh, man. I should probably go back. Don't trust that well. Random wells in the middle of a wilderness. City wells, okay. Nothing. Damn it. Man, hearing loud, Gorath heard a loud sound. Grasping for his only means of defense, he planted his feet firmly and waited while his stomach tied itself in knots. Oh shit, witch hag. Gorath paralyzed. Okay. Ideally, she won't stun Owen, although I don't think she'll be able to. No, she's just gonna fucking kill Gorath. That's troublesome. You leave my tank alone! Okay, that's fine. I just need him to survive long enough for Owen to do this. Where is he? There he is. All right, we just won the fight. Okay, now I need to think about how we're going to win the fight. So I can... I don't think I'm gonna be able to lightning bolt this thing. I'll try it. I have the Idol of Lesur. No, okay, so we can't lightning bolt that thing. I do have the idol, which will instant kill things. But part of me thinks I probably really want to save that. But on the other side, this thing could, like, stun Owen and we'll just die. So I think I'm going to use a charge. Though the eyelids of the heavy idol had been carved closed, they flickered open, revealing a pair of rat-like eyes. Owen choked as a cold feminine voice began to speak through him. I call to my halls the chosen by the one who bears my image. Choose one to die, Owen. That's dark. I like it. That one. Okay, so can we use this, like, if there's a final boss in this?
Can I use that on the final boss? Let me know in the comments. I don't even, like, if we can somehow get it to whatever party needs it. That is a powerful, powerful item. And that it has 8 uses is, like, crazy to me. Assuming that's actually true. Is it still, does it say 7 now? Yeah, holy shit. Like, 8 guaranteed kills. That is no joke. Come on, Gorath, I need you to put your damn big boy pants on and start murdering things. Today, preferably. I mean, I could just have Owen go around pocket sanding all of these things, I guess. I'm basically just having him rest for mana right now. Come on, Gorath. I don't even know how he's doing hit point wise. I assume he's probably pretty bad off. Can I? He's like, 44 of 83. He's kind of in a bad spot. Not insurmountable, though. He's just sitting over there, kind of swaying back and forth. Come on. Like, I'm not worried about the skin of the dragon wearing off of him, I was gonna say, but I am worried about it wearing off of Owen, and conveniently enough, it just did, but also conveniently enough, I have pocket sand. So I'm gonna just go ahead and step Owen back here. They can continue flailing ineffectually. And now we're gonna get some use out of the infinity pool. Let's see how this sucker works. Let's see here, where's Evil Seek? Owen have Evil Seek? I honestly don't remember. I don't think he does. Crap. Alright. Flame cast it is then. Eat fiery seriously? Seriously? Fine, eat fiery death. That should AoE out. Probably hit this one? No. Just Owen. I don't even think I did. Oh my god. This game. It's trolling. Skin of the dragon. 20. Gorath, come on, man. I need you here. Is there a dispel magic? I can't remember. I've got so many spells. Seal Fire ain't gonna do it. Invitation ain't gonna do it. Unfortunate Flux. Summon Sprites. Terrifying, by the way. Reflex Projectiles. Invisible Armor. Eh. I'm just gonna have Owen rest again. Okay, so Gorath is now in danger. Which means I'm immediately just going to pop another 20 point skin of the dragon on him. Did that ice spell wear off of him? And it did, conveniently. Holy shit, that lasted for like 20 rounds of combat. Cause I hit him with a full powered skin of the dragon there. Wow, that is kind of absurd. You Gorath. When we get back down to one of these things, I'm just gonna have the party nap. What was that? I clicked on this thing and Gorath's like, yeah, I'm just gonna nap. Maybe he did attack and it's just hard to notice. All right. I'm sure this is gonna wear off of this thing. Gotta keep an eye on it. Okay, Owen. You were at 35. I'm gonna go ahead and have Owen cast health transfer here. Where is it? Oh, it was on the first one, naturally. Where is it? Where's Gift of Song? There it is. Gorath some health, because he's got such a large pool that by the time he's fully charged up, Owen will be too. All right, so Owen is in danger now, so I'm gonna have Gorath more melee once so that this thing's within a strike of death. I don't expect this stun to last a whole heck of a lot longer. Wow. That fight was more dangerous than it had any right to be. Oh god, I don't know where that freaking caster's corpse is. It's probably buried out here somewhere. Oh my god. Nice try, game. Freaking flame root oil. Amazing. And we're also, conveniently enough, half an hour, so I guess I'm gonna go ahead and call it here. So, as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. I hope you had a good time. And I will catch you all next time where the adventure continues. Until then.